What is up, my loves? Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Leizel, and today's video is going to be something a little bit different. I decided to do half my face in drugstore makeup and the other half in high-end makeup. I'm pretty much just going to be putting a bunch of products to the test, seeing how they compare in terms of formula, performance, color, wearing abilities, you know, that kind of thing. I'm pretty much just going to be putting a bunch of products on my face and seeing how they compare and seeing whether we can get a little bit more out of our money, because I know all of us love high-end products, but guys, drugstore products are the bomb as well. Like, I have a lot of drugstore products within my collection, so I figured why not compare them to high-end, see what is really worth the money, and I thought you guys would be interested to see. But before we get started, I want you guys to comment down below and let me know which side of my face do you think is drugstore and which side do you think is high-end, because I'm really curious to see whether you guys can tell the difference. So yeah, take a look at my face, have a little bit of a study. Which side do you think is high-end or drugstore? Let me know down below. No cheating, don't skip forward. I want you to tell me before you watch the video. Alrighty, so with all that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new here so you don't miss any of the other videos. And with that being said, let's get started. Alrighty, as you guys can see, I have absolutely no makeup on my face. I don't even have my brows on. I don't even have brows. So let's first start off with brows. First of all, I'm gonna be doing this side of my face high-end and this side drugstore. I've literally got like everything on my desk. All the high-end stuff is on this side and all the drugstore stuff is on this side. So yeah, let's start with the brows. Funny story, actually, I was grooming my brows and I accidentally shaved off the end of this one. So that was not fun. Thank God for brow pomade though, because I don't know what I would do without it. For my high-end side, I'm gonna be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dipbrow Pomade. The shade that I use is dark brown. Dipbrow is literally, like, I don't know what I did before it. I love the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dipbrow, and I feel like I'll use it every single day for the rest of my life. And then of course for my other brow, I'm gonna be using the Chi Chi Brow Pomade. This was actually my first ever dip brow, or like brow pomade actually, and this like changed the game for me. So this is like my OG brow product. I love it, and I think like I should use it more often than I do, because it's like, it was number one for me. Like it was the game changer. All right, so brows are done. I actually really like them both. Like I feel like they're pretty much the exact same product. They're very, very similar in consistency and in the way that they apply. So I would recommend that if you do want to try the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade, then check out the Chi Chi one because it is much more affordable. I'm gonna move on to doing my base now. So I'm gonna prime. For the high-end side of my face, I'm going to be using the Too Faced HangoveRX primer. I think that's what it's called. I love this primer. I literally use this primer every single day. It smells so nice and it just feels really nice when you're applying it to the skin. And then for the drugstore side, I'm going to be using the Face of Australia Face Base Primer. I actually realized that I don't really have many drugstore like hydrating primers in my collection. I have a lot of drugstore pore filling primers because back in the day, like my pores were insane. But these days I don't really have much in terms of pores to fill in. So this is the only like hydrating primer that I have. I'd have to say though that I am liking the feeling of this one more. Like the consistency of the products feels very similar, but this one feels a lot more lightweight and I feel like it sinks into the skin a lot quicker. Onto foundation now, I'm just shaking it up. I'm using the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation. If you guys watch my videos regularly, then you know that this is like my obsession. I love this foundation, especially when I was going through my crazy acne days. This was like clutch for me, like it really pulled through for me. I think the main reason why I like this foundation so much is because you can apply such a small amount, but it gives you such good coverage. And if you do want to have like really intense full coverage, then you can go ahead and apply more. But if you just want like a decent amount of coverage, one thin layer is fine. For the drugstore side, I'm going to be using the Milani Conceal and Perfect Foundation. This stuff, oh my goodness, it's like a recent discovery of mine. I recently did a first impressions on it and I've been obsessed with it ever since. Such a good foundation for the price. I think it's like 10 bucks in the US and $20 for Australians. It's amazing. And don't worry guys, even though I'm using the same sponge, I'm using different sides so that the formulas don't mix with one another as I'm blending them in. Alrighty, foundation is done. I think one side of my face is actually slightly darker in shade compared to the other, but that's okay, we're gonna work with it. I'm actually going out after I film this video, so I hope I don't look too crazy. I'm gonna move on to concealer now. So for the high-end side, I'm going to be using the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. This is like my ride or die concealer. I have used it for the longest time. This concealer was actually probably my first ever high-end concealer that I bought, and I've been in love with it ever since. To blend this in, I'm just using a Models Prefer airbrush concealer brush. If I want my concealer to be really full coverage and concentrated, then I definitely prefer using a brush like this because I feel like it keeps the product on your face. Whereas if you're using a beauty blender, it does take away some of the product. Then for the drugstore side of my face, I'm going to be using the LA Girl Pro Conceal Concealer. A lot of people have said that this is comparable to the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, and I would have to agree because for the price, I was like shook, like I couldn't believe how good of a concealer it was and how comparable it was to the MAC Pro Longwear. Now I just have to set the concealer. So for the high-end side, I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. To be honest, even though this says it's translucent, I feel like it's not because in the container, it does have a little bit of like color to it, but I still love it regardless. For the drugstore side, I'm going to be using the Astralis. Can you guys see that? Is it upside down? Yes, it's upside down. The Astralis Ready Set Go Translucent Setting Powder. This powder, you guys, it is honestly my favorite translucent setting powder ever. And it's so inexpensive, so I can just like pack it on for days and I'm not even mad about it because it's so inexpensive. I don't actually have any high-end pressed powders, so what I'm gonna do is just take a little bit of that Laura Mercier powder and dust it over that half. And then I'm going to also dust a bit of the Astralis powder on the drugstore side of my face. All right, so now that my base is done, I'm going to be moving on to the eyes. I decided they're not exactly the same, but I feel like they are very similar. I'm using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette and the Chi Chi Spices palette. As you guys can see, they're not exactly the same, but they are very similar in the sense of the tones and shades that they carry. First of all, I'm just going to apply a base. So I'm using the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre, one of my favorites. And then for the drugstore side, I'm going to be using the NYX eyeshadow base. This is just their skin tone colored one. I feel like these products are very similar. As you can see, they're both skin tone shades and they both apply very similarly in the sense that they are a cream. So I like them both. I actually did have the NYX one first and I really liked it. So I would totally recommend this one to you guys. I'm also just quickly going to set those in place with the translucent powders that I used for my face. So I'm going to start off with my crease transitional shade. So I'm going to be taking Burnt Orange from the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette, and I'm going to be using this shade right here. I feel like they do look somewhat similar. I love the Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow formulas. This palette was actually the first time I ever tried Anastasia Beverly Hills shadows and I fell in love. So I really do have love for this palette because the formula is just everything. As you guys can see, the colors are similar, but I feel like maybe this Chi Chi shadow that I'm using right now is a little more like red toned, whereas the Rialga shade is a little more orange. And to be honest, this formula of these shadows, like, they don't do a bad job. They're quite easy to blend out. As you guys can see, I've had no problems. And yeah, although the shades do look a little bit different, but we're just gonna roll with it. To add a little more depth to that crease, I'm going to be using Rialga. I think I said I was using Rialga before, but I was using Burnt Orange. Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna be using Rialga, which is just this beautiful, like, Moroccan orange type of shade. And I'm going to be taking this shade out of the palette, the Chi Chi Spices palette. So they do look very similar. For the lid shade, I really wanted to do like a gold, but there's no golds within these palettes that match each other. However, the shade Antique Bronze It's like a pinky, kind of brownish, reddish shade. Does look very similar to this shade right here. Like, I feel like they look very similar. So I think I am going to just try that on my lids and see how it goes. This is a really beautiful shade. I have not used this shade out of the palette yet, but I really like it. Okay, now that I'm applying it to my eye, not that similar, but there is another shade in here that has kind of the same tone going on, so I'm gonna mix a bit of this shade in as well. Oh my gosh, you know what, guys? These shadows are actually much more pigmented. What? Like, can you see that color payoff right there? I've just spot cleaned my brush and I'm gonna add a little bit more of that antique bronze shade to the high-end side because I'm very curious as to why the drugstore side is so much more pigmented. Onto the outer corner of my eyes now, I'm gonna be taking Cyrus Umber. I'm gonna be taking this shade from the Chi Chi palette. They aren't exactly the same, like obviously the Chi Chi one does have sparkles in it. They are very similar, so we're just gonna do what we can do. All right, outer corners are done, and now we're going to do a little bit of inner corner highlight because you guys know how much I like to do that. So I'm going to take, let's see what we're working with, Vermeer. It's like this shimmery skin tone color, so I'm going to do this on the high end side. Look at that pop. And then I'm going to take this shade right here for the drugstore side. Oh, okay. Dang, all right. Chi Chi, bringing in the goods. All right, we're gonna be doing some winged liner now. So I'm going to be using the Inglot Gel Eyeliner for the high-end side and the L'Oreal Superliner 24-Hour Gel Liner for the drugstore. I definitely have to say that the Inglot one is a lot easier to work with, but the L'Oreal one didn't do too bad. However, the Inglot one is definitely like more intense and more black, as you guys can tell. Now I'm going to line my eyes. I'm using the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Liner for the high-end side and my NYX Retractable Eyeliner for the drugstore. Why is my eye leaking right now? Like, the Urban Decay side is just so intense. I mean, it even made me cry, so yeah, no. I'm just applying that same orangey shade that I used on the lid along the bottom lash line as well. And then just to kind of darken it up a little bit, I'm gonna take those same shades that I used on the outer corners of my eyes and run those closer to my lash line. Alrighty, so I'm going to be applying mascara now. I will be using the Too Faced Better Than Sex Waterproof Mascara on this side and the Maybelline Colossal Big Shot Mascara for this side. So yes, I will actually be applying some lashes. I'm going to be using the Siren Lashes from House of Lashes and also the Coco Lashes in the Style Misha. They're not exactly the same, but I feel like they are very similar. So I'm gonna put them on, one in each eye, and see how they go. They're so similar, guys. Like, they look very similar. If we're talking about length, I think the Coco Lashes in the Style Misha are a little bit like longer, but they are virtually the same. Like, they're very, very similar. Alrighty, so now that the eyes are all done, I'm gonna move back onto the face. I will be contouring now, and I'm gonna use the Kat Von D Shade and Light Contouring Palette and the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro Palette. I'm gonna take this shade right here from the Kat Von D palette and just contour. Oh, I love this contour shade. I only recently started using it and like, I just questioned myself, like, why did I not use this sooner? And then for something similar, I'm gonna be taking this shade here from the NYX palette. Oh, that's not bad actually. I really like that. Wow, okay. Pigmentation, we see you. God damn. All right, I'm just gonna contour my nose. You all know I've been really into contouring my nose lately, especially because a lot of you guys gave me so many lovely compliments on my nose contour in my Instagram baddie makeup tutorial. So I was like, yeah, gotta contour the nose. Next up, I'm going to bronze. I'll be using none other than the MAC Give Me Sun bronzer on this side of my face and the Milani Baked bronzer. How pretty is this packaging, guys? Like, the packaging itself, I'm just like living for. You all know how much I love MAC Give Me Sun. Ooh, yeah, love this stuff. I like probably apply a little bit too much all the time, always, because I just continually am like packing it on, but it really is that good, especially if you have like skin tone similar to mine. If you do have like a lighter skin tone and you are a little more pale, I probably wouldn't recommend it. Oh, my brush is shedding. But for those of you guys who are a little bit tanned, this is just gonna like uplift you. The Milani bronzer also does have like a little bit of like a gold sheen to it, which the MAC bronzer doesn't. But in terms of color, they are very similar. It's just that this has like gold veining throughout it, which is pretty cool. It gives like a really cool effect. Alrighty, for blush now, I'm going to be going with like a peachy toned blush. So I'm going to be using the Tarte Amazonian Clay 12 Hour Blush in Captivating. It's like this really nice peachy toned. And then I'm going to be using another Milani product for this side of my face. This is the infamous Milani Baked Blush in Luminoso. I don't know why I had to look at the back, like I should know that off by heart. They are a little bit different, but they do give off like the same color, so... Wow, okay. The thing I love about the Milani blush is that it does have a sheen to it, which of course the Tarte blush doesn't. But as you can see, they're very similar. So I'm loving them both. On to highlighting now. I'm going to be using the Laura Geller Gilded Honey Highlighter for this side of my face. Like, just look at this. Highlighter is honestly my favorite part when it comes to makeup application. Like just sprinkling that highlighter onto my face is like everything. And then for this side of my face, I'm going to be using the Sleek Highlighting Palette in Cleopatra's Kiss. I think I'm just gonna take that gold shade up the top there. It's really hard to hold like multiple products and point things out, but you guys get the gist. Like they are very similar. Yes. You guys don't understand like how much I love applying highlighter. Just look at the glow. I could go for days. I could apply highlighter forever. I can't really do like half of my nose and half of my Cupid's bow, so I'm just gonna put the Laura Geller one on my nose. Oh my gosh, you guys, look at that. Like that is insane. Honestly, this palette itself comes with four highlighters and it's only $12 in the US and $25 in Australia. Wow, that's actually blinding. Like that's too much, isn't it? Okay then. That's saying something. For my lips, I did find something that was very similar. So I'm going to be lining my lips half with Strip Down by MAC and half with Centerfold by Chi Chi. The MAC one is definitely more pigmented, that's for sure. And then for my lip color, I'm going to be using the Too Faced Melt and Matte Liquid Lipstick in Child Star and the NYX Lip Lingerie in Lace Detail. Can I just say it's really weird to be applying things to like half of my lips and half of my face. It's just very uncomfortable. These colors actually look a lot more similar on the lips than they did when I swatched them, so that's a good thing. We're done, you guys. That's everything. Alrighty, guys, this is the completed look. Let me know in the comments down below which side you guys prefer, whether it's the high-end side or the drugstore side. Personally, there's different aspects of each side that I prefer, like I'm really living for the eye look on this side of my face. But I'm really, really liking this highlight. Like, can we just take a moment? So that's pretty much it for today's video. If you guys enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you aren't subscribed already so you don't miss any of the videos I post. Also, I want you guys to let me know what other videos you want to see from me. I really want to do like a one brand tutorial, so I want to get like a bunch of Maybelline products and do a one brand tutorial, or some Wet n Wild products and do a one brand tutorial. Let me know what you want to see from me down below. And with that being said, I hope you're all having an awesome week and I will catch you all in my next video. Stay glowy.